I'm Dom Smith, and here's a story you should know.
Sitcoms like Good Times, The Jeffersons, and Sanford and Son are credited for pushing black families to the mainstream. Before these shows, it was an extremely rare sight to see a black family on television. That all changed when Eric Monte became a writer on All in the Family. Monte is quietly credited with creating the characters of George and Louise Jefferson, who eventually got their own spinoff, The Jeffersons, in 1975. In addition to creating the characters, Monte also created Good Times, another early portrayal of a black family. Despite working on some of the most innovative and groundbreaking sitcoms in TV history, Eric Monte has nothing to show for it, after attempting to sue the networks and producers for not getting the credit he deserves. Norman Lear, according to Monte, had him blackballed from Hollywood. Battling evictions, homelessness, and a drug addiction, Monte's life had completely changed from when he was driving a Mercedes in Los Angeles. Eric Monte's big break would occur after moving to California from Chicago. Monte met and became friends with actor Mike Evans while taking theater classes at Los Angeles City College. Evans would go on to play Lionel Jefferson in All in the Family and The Jeffersons. While on All in the Family, Evans had asked Monte to help him expand the character of Lionel. Monte wrote a script and submitted it to Norman Lear. The writing had impressed Lear, and he hired Monte as a writer. While working on All in the Family, Monte pitched the idea of George Jefferson being added to the show, and it wasn't long before George and Louise Jefferson made their first appearances. In fact, Monte initially tried to pitch a show for George Jefferson, but Lear told Monte that the show was too controversial and executives wouldn't accept a show where a black man calls a white man a honky. In the early 70s, Norman Lear told Monte about a potential American remake of a UK show, Steptoe and Son. At the time, Lear wasn't aware of Fox, but had plans for an all-white cast. Now, surprisingly to Monte, months would go by, and the remake would debut in January 1972 as Sanford and Son, with Red Fox in the starring role. According to Monte, he would not receive credit for his input. In 1974, Monte collaborated with Mike Evans to create Good Times, which was executive produced and developed by Norman Lear. While making Good Times, Monte said that the show's plots were laced with stereotypical images and dialogue written by white writers who didn't understand black life. All the white writers wanted stereotypes. I refused. Every week we'd argue and fight, they would ignore what I suggested and take all that Yeza Boss stuff to the cast, and John Amos and Esther Rolle would have a fit. Monte would then give the cast what he wrote, and when the cast accepted, Norman Lear reluctantly filmed it. After the first season, Monte was demoted after doing 80% of the rewrites while the white writers were promoted. Monte claims he was demoted because he would always side with the cast when they objected to the stereotypical scripts that the white writers came up with. Tensions on set would further escalate as both lead actors John Amos and Esther Rolle voiced their frustrations toward the lack of direction in the show, specifically with the character JJ, played by Jimmy Walker. The writers would prefer to put a chicken hat on JJ and have him prance around saying dynamite, and that way they could waste a few minutes and not have to write meaningful dialogue. With Amos's increasing demands, Norman Lear wanted to fire him. According to Monte, Lear thought the people wouldn't accept a strong black father in the home. Both John Amos and Eric Monte went back and forth with the crew. Lear eventually fired Amos against the wishes of Monte. In 1975, I got the contract to write Cooley High, a movie following the antics of black teenagers living in Chicago's Cabrini Green Apartments where I grew up. When American International Pictures and Samuel Arkoff sent the cast to Chicago to shoot the movie, I left Good Times. After Monte left Good Times and completed Cooley High, Norman Lear created The Jeffersons. The Jeffersons ran for 11 seasons and became the longest-running black sitcom at the time. Although Monte never worked on the show, he did create the characters George and Louise Jefferson. Monte's name was left off the credits. In 1976, Monte would then go on to create the series What's Happening. The series would be based off of Cooley High, which was also written by Monte. When building the show, Monte wanted the show under his own production company, but because he had no prior experience when it came to producing his own show, the network provided two producers for him. When Monte showed up to set, he found out that the two producers formed a company with Bud Yorkin, who had previously worked with Norman Lear on Good Times and Sanford and Son. Monte's agent negotiated the deal behind his back, and as a result, Monte filed a lawsuit against ABC, CBS, and the producers of What's Happening, including Norman Lear. Eric would pitch an idea, and the next thing that would happen is there would be a character in a series, and he was barely getting paid for it. He'd come up with an idea for a show, but when all the dust cleared, it was their show, and he was going to be hired only as a writer. After I filed the lawsuit, nobody would work with him. According to an interview with Real Black TV, Lear offered Monte a $1 million settlement for all the shows he was attached to, which Monte declined. The lawyers then tried to convince Monte to take on the settlement because the lawsuit against the networks was still outstanding. Under this advice, Monte accepted. When the time came for the trial, Monte saw all the defendants listed in the case and was told by his lawyers, "Either you take this or we're walking off the case." This would prove to be awful timing because the statute of limitations would run out within a week. Monte searched all over Los Angeles for new lawyers to represent him, and he had the evidence to prove it. However, Monte was unsuccessful in finding someone to take the case and eventually took the settlement. Due to his lack of experience, business knowledge, and legal representation, Monte did not receive royalties for the shows he created, only a settlement and a small ownership of Good Times. After the lawsuit, Monte was blacklisted by other producers in Hollywood who labeled him too difficult to work with. After not being able to find work in television, Monte turned to theater, where he used his own money to finance a play. Unfortunately, the play was unsuccessful. Monte continued to pitch scripts for television, but only two were bought. A 1999 episode of The Wayans Brothers, and an episode of Moesha in 2001. Unable to sell more scripts, Monte lost his home and all of his money. He slept on park benches while living off the occasional low-paying writing jobs and residual income from Good Times. By 2003, Monte developed an addiction to crack. People around me were getting high on crack and I decided to give it a try, and that was a major mistake. The only thing crack did for me was give me a tremendous desire for more. I did it for 2 years and gave it up. Once Monte left Los Angeles, he relocated to Portland, Oregon with his daughter. Finally free from the temptations of drugs, he was able to get back on track. Lear had declined to comment on the case, saying, "I don't want to traffic in that. Whatever the credits reflect, I'm happy to go along with. It pains me deeply to hear that he's homeless. Eric is a lovable, knowledgeable, sweet human being who just had no control of himself. He got in his own way emotionally. He was a dear lost soul. It wasn't a pleasant time dealing with Eric. Norman Lear is a racist, a hypocrite, a thief, and a liar." Those were Eric Monte's words in the 2006 Unseen interview uploaded by Real Black. That same year, it was reported that Monte was living in a Salvation Army shelter in California. Acknowledging the pros of living in a shelter, Monte said the shelter allows the peace and privacy to create, write, and rewrite TV. The Good Times cast has been on the Steve Harvey Show, and Norman Lear did a whole show with Oprah talking about Good Times and the Jeffersons, including the Black-ish season finale that was a tribute to Good Times. That was advertised on Good Morning America and The View. There was not one question about me, the creator of those shows. Monte's dreams of becoming a writer that doesn't focus on black stereotypes had been partially accomplished, and he knows more work needs to be done. Monte said, "I wanted to prove to everyone, Hollywood producers and their writers, that I knew what I was doing and that positive stories about blacks could work." Monte still writes television and film scripts with plans on selling them. When Monte first decided that he wanted to become a writer, one of his main goals was to create black heroes. Monte wanted to inspire black children to become doctors, lawyers, and world leaders, instead of gang members, dope fiends, and criminals. Unfortunately, it comes as no surprise that Monte was robbed of what he worked for. We've seen this happen before in show business, where talented artists are taught hard lessons through experience. Hopefully, the 76-year-old Monte will one day get the credit he deserves.
I didn't come out here just to make movies and make money. I came out here to make history, and I ain't finished yet.